it's more like an obsession now. Everything I deal with is something to deal with this, you know? Everything I... It's always in my head. I'm always thinking about it. Yeah, I'm definitely obsessed with it.
I'm in here every goddamn day. I live here. I don't know, it's 7 o'clock now or something like that. I won't be out here till after midnight. I'll be here, everyone will be gone and I'll still be here.
If you ever get to a stage where you're saying, you're looking at something and saying, nah, that doesn't work, that's, my way is better. That's the wrong way of thinking. You want to learn absolutely everything, you want to absorb everything. And you want to be perfect, you know, you're looking for perfection. I'll take the long
way around. Give me time, because trust me when I tell you this is the greatest of all time.
Very few human beings in this world will ever experience anything remotely similar to what's going on inside the mind and the body of Conor McGregor as he steps into this octagon. Big, deep breath by Chad Mendes.
Listen to this place.
Oh, big shot by McGregor.
Look at the clock closely. 10 seconds.
Oh, he's hurt.
Could he finish him here?
Here it
is. It's all over. Conor McGregor is a UFC.
Wow.
Interim featherweight champion.
Wow. This now sets up a fight with Jose Aldo that will be easily the biggest fight in the history of the UFC.
If he wants to come back, he can come back, but I swear to God, his day will be.
I will be a ghost in there. He will think I'm there, and then I am not there. He will think I am not there, and then I am there.
The most highly anticipated featherweight fight of all time.
This is not the guy who was joking and laughing and almost immature with how he fought in the first Diaz contest. Now he is ready, calm, patient, focused.
Champion against champion. McGregor looking to make history.
You're talking about a guy who is a master of distance management, who has a piston left hand that is accurate, that is brilliantly timed, that is versatile.
I've ridiculed everyone on the roster. I just want to say from the bottom of my heart, I'd like to take this chance to apologize to absolutely nobody. The double champ does what the he wants.
He's got some beef with Khabib because of the Artem thing that went down. You could do whatever you wanted to Khabib within the limits of the rules of fighting, but you want to grab 30 fucking friends and come down here and do what you did today? It's disgusting. And I don't think anybody is going to be huge Conor McGregor fans after this.
Police arresting the star fighter after he reportedly smashed a fan's phone.
When you get wild motherfuckers like John Jones, they've got greatness in them, but there's also chaos. And this is Conor McGregor's chaos. This is what you're getting from him right now.
Light the game up for the fans and to create fanfare and to see them disappointed in me, it hurts me to my soul more than you'll ever know. Like I said, retribution, redemption, respect. I will come and I will regain all of those.
Build myself back up. That's what allowed me to achieve the things I achieved. It was consistency, consecutive bouts, back to back. This is the beginning of my 2020 season. I'm going to remind everyone and then continue to climb.
Who has gone out there time and time again? Back to back to back to back. Putting it all on the line and continuing to show up. They all say I'm on top. I look at them and say they're on top because I'm the one in here fighting everything. You want what I got? You gotta put in the fucking work. And as far as I'm seeing, nobody's putting in the work.
I'm going to win every belt, and then I'm gone. And then I'll see the game later. I'll walk away from this game. I'll set it ablaze and walk away.